Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. I received a comment. Please make a video to check frequency on ceramic resonator 328 3 pin 8 megahertz. If we see in this sharp air conditioner board, here we have oscillator 1. It is 8.00. this is frequency 8 megahertz. It is a clock generator. It is a resonant, like a crystal circuit. How to test its frequency? Why we need to test frequency when the board is dead? At that time we need to verify either the resonant is good, the clock signal is available, and either the reset signal is available. First of all, for safety purpose, we will insulate these wires, because we are powering on directly this board. So isolate these three wires, because we are not going to connect anything with this board. We will just power it on. Now I removed the fuse already. The fuse is removed. We will not apply power to the compressor relay and other stuff. We will directly power on, because we are going to work with this board. We are not going to work with the high power section. If you don't have a good practical experience in power electronics, never try to repair. Never do any experiments. It is for your safety. I will connect two jumpers across the primary winding of the transformer. It is 220 volt operated board. I will connect one wire here, the second wire at this terminal, so that we bypassed the service switch, we bypassed the fuse. We will use series lamp to apply power. Then we will make jumper for these two connectors. That are these white one and the red one. CN11 and CN12. Red and white. This is for test purpose. I am not connecting any type of sensor, because we want to just power it on, so that we can test the signal. So for temporary basis, I will connect jumper, so that our these 12 volts will pass to the next circuit, and our 5 volt regulator will start, and 5 volt will reach to the next circuit. So it is in the path of 5 volts. Now our circuit is ready to power on. I connected just indicator panel. Here is our oscillator, and we will test the frequency of this oscillator between the center pin, between the center pin and the one pin closer to the microcontroller, that is this one here, with the center one and with the right one. This is the output pin here. For that purpose, I can make a ground point here. We will not go too much closer to the microcontroller. I will make a small jumper here, slightly away from the oscillator and the processor, to hook up the ground of my oscilloscope. Because it is high frequency, we cannot test with multimeter. I will hook the ground here. Now our board is clear, and I will connect supply with the series lamp. Always take care for the safety. So this time we are bypassing the fuse, but we are applying power through the series lamp, so it is safe. Now I will apply power, and I will turn on oscilloscope. You can see when I powered on this board, the processor started, and it is now illuminating, showing the error. set probe to 1x and select in the software probe at 1x and connect to the rightmost pin that is closer to the controller. Auto set. This is our signal. It is 8 megahertz, 8.00. It is 8.00 megahertz, and this signal is in this shape. And if we check the left pin, that is also 8 megahertz, but its amplitude is low. And this is our clock signal. It is 8 megahertz signal. If this signal is present, and if the reset signal is present, clock is present, the processor must work. Yes, it is 8 megahertz. In this way, we can test the frequency. I hope so. You enjoyed this video. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any questions, write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.